Though we tend this month to be the month that we magnify the Lord, the month that we praise God, it says, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. But today, being the last Sunday of the year, being the 52nd Sunday of this year, 2019, I want us to have a time of reflection, a time of thinking, a time of looking through what God has deposited in us throughout the whole year, and to ask ourselves, how faithful have we been? It is not something that we want to say, we want to think about concerning the faithfulness of God. God has been faithful unto us, otherwise we will not be here today. God has indeed blessed us from January to December. He indeed brought his words to come to pass. It said it's our year of Shekinah and our year of sufficiency. He said it's our year of Shekinah because he said he will be with us. Even when we are going through the storm, through trouble, he said he will be with us. And when I look back, I can indeed say that God was with us. He said it's our year of sufficiency, meaning that we will always have what to eat, what to drink, what to clothe, to use to clothe ourselves, a covering. And we can be able to even help other people. Is there anyone that has lacked? Is there anyone among us that has not been able to some extent fulfill or have done the things that you have said you are going to do? I'm not talking of spiritual, I'm talking of physical. I want to say categorically 100% that none of us is in the same level that we were in January. But my question is, in which level have you advanced? God always gives us every month what we are supposed to use as a foundational background, as a foundation to build something on in that month. I remember this year, after the Open Doors to Glory revival, after we learned about Shekinah and sufficiency, in February we learned about abiding in the presence of God. Abiding in the presence of God. Where we said that Jesus is the door. He said, I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved, and we go in and out and find pasture. Everyone that took in this word in February, they already have testimony. If you don't have a testimony, it means that you neglected it. Remember, the Bible said about the story of the kingdom of God in the book of Matthew 24, talking about the talents. The Bible said that, and when the man wanted to travel, the man called his servants and gave some of them five talents. To the other, he gave two. To the other, he gave one. Every month, God is giving us talents. God is giving us talent. The talent he gave us this year was, is your year of Shekinah and sufficiency. When he gives us everything, he leaves us to do something with what he has given. March, we talk about prosperity in Shekinah. We learn that he said that the blessings of God make rich and add no sorrow to it. He said also, beloved, above all things, I want you to prosper. Even as your soul prospered, did you key into these words? What have you done with these talents that God has given us as a church? When we got to April, we started talking about Jesus in Shekinah. I'm reflecting on what we have learned this year. Jesus in Shekinah, that is Jesus in the presence, in the appearance of God. until we learn that one thing that is important that we need to know in our life is that Jesus is our Lord and our Savior. That means he's our deliverer and our hope for salvation, our hope to be free from any trouble. These are what God has been teaching us. Can you say today that your life reflects, that your life is a testimony of somebody who knows the importance of Jesus, that can indeed say, in everything, in all things, Jesus is my deliverer. Jesus is my salvation. That because of Jesus, as I key unto him, because he's the door, I'm very sure that nothing can destroy me. That in every situation, I am saved. I am secured. The talents he gave to us. This year, 2019, what did you do? When we got to June, he said it is the power of grace. What is the meaning of grace? Meaning of grace is that someone who comes there to take care of the things, to pay the price, to suffer for you, to give you everything that you need, make it to be available so that you can live a good life. There we learned, according to Psalm 84, he said, for the Lord is a sword and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from those that walk uprightly. That was what we learned in the month of June. That God is the God that does not withhold. He does not stop anyone from getting blessing as long as you are walking upright. What have you done with that talent? Did you even receive the talent? 5 talents he gave. 2 talents he gave. 1 talent he gave. And then he watched the church and is looking at the people, because there is a time when you have to present. And today is the last Sunday, a day of presentation to God, what I have done with that talent. I hope you are hearing.
Yes.
We got to July. We received the power of the Holy Ghost. God spoke to us, telling us that without his spirit, you cannot be able to perfect in anything. He said, for you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has done what has come upon you. The book of Acts 1:8. And what will you be? You will become a witness. That means even without you opening your mouth to speak, one can see Christ in you. He said, I've empowered you through the Holy Ghost to be a witness. That means when they look at you, if you actually took the power, that talent, and walk with it and trade with it, it will be reflected in your life. Did it reflect in your life?
Yes.
The power of the Holy Ghost, can one look at you and be able to say, wow, this is somebody who the Holy Spirit is living inside. I had yes, but you come to church after 11. New beginning and balance is what we learned in the month of August. Why? Because the enemy struck and there was kind of turbulence, but God is a God of comfort. He said, don't worry about what the enemy has done. Don't worry about whom the enemy has taken. It is also meant for you to reflect, to stand strong in me. He says, start all over. Don't allow depression and suppression to enter into you. August, he gave us another talent, another foundational truth to work on. He said, your month of new beginning, that there is a time that you have to stop and think before you move. You have to stop and look before you do anything. He said, behold, I create for you a new earth and a new heaven. All things are passed away. Everything has become new. And then as you enter into that journey, start working with it. He said, now is the time I'm going to stretch out my hand to help you. we got into September, help from above. He said, what shall we say to all these things according to the book of Romans 8? If God be for us, who can be against us? No. Rekindle our confidence in Him. Rekindle our faith in Him. That you should know one thing, whatever can make you to be successful, it must be in Christ. True success is found in Christ. True money is found in Christ. True peace is found in Christ. So I can help you to live a life that you must live. Say, so we have to ask God, God, indeed, according to what you have given us, Shekinah, be with me. Because if God is with us, none can be against us. As we saw in the book of Romans 8:13. And then we went to October, we said, reply the devil. Now we don't strong. Now we are strong enough to tell the devil, get thee behind me. And I hope you are strong. Say, reply the devil. I have already gathered so much knowledge that I know that when God is with me, devil, who are you? He tempted Jesus. Jesus said, man can live only in the word of God, not bread. In this year, is your life so tied up to God that material things and food is not the primary reason why you are living, but Christ? That was the message. And then we enter November. What did we learn? Prepare the way. Why? Because you are going close to another journey where we will start gathering other talents. That every good thing that happens, there is always a preparation that goes before it. Every good thing that happens, even bad things that happens, there is always preparation. The day one dies, it's not the day that death was prepared. It's not the one, not the formulator says. The day you become lotto winner, a millionaire, it's not the day that the money cannot be by luck. There is already a preparation towards it. Prepare the way. Before Jesus came, a lot of prophecies have prepared the way. John the Baptist came, prepared the way. Even spiritually, we saw Anna and Simon preparing the way, praying every day so that the prophecy can come to pass. Somebody is praying for you. It is not helpful. Somebody is praying for you. Even someone that you don't even know. I remember when Prophet Simon was talking to somebody. He said, there is so person that is called so person in your family. That one said yes. And that one was doing chakra that the person she hates the person. And then Prophet Simon said, you better go and reconcile with him because he's praying for you. That one that was praying for her was part of those whom she's considering as evil. That means how much she's enjoying, because you know they can't touch her, and once in the blue moon, and they fight with myself. Amen?
Amen.
And they are like, the person they fight with me, and once in the blue moon, they can't touch. Then you're going to do chakra, they go, kwe, it is a nice good pass. Prophet open man said, forget. Somebody did Naija and as a soul person. And you don't like the person. But the person they pray for you. I don't know whether you should not reconcile with that person. So why is that person, God put it in the heart of that one to be praying for her despite her behavior to him? Because God has something to fulfill in the life of that young lady. That manipulation is manipulating her. But because God wants his purposes to be fulfilled in her life, God is telling somebody, help, so that she will not fail to tell. But it gets stage where God will reach. God will say, now you serve me. Prepare the way. And we prepare into our divine visitation. And indeed, we are divinely visited. My question is this. When God came, when that man came back from the journey, Matthew 25, he came to them, the one who had the 5 talents, said, Lord, at the beginning of the year, you gave me 5 talents. I traded with it, and I have 5 talents now. two said, you gave me two talents. I traded with it and I have two more. The ones with one said, you are useless human being. Is it only one you give me? Which among these people are you? Today, that is the last Sunday. Have you traded with your five talents? And can you present to God today additional five talents? Can you give to God today additional two talents? How can you be able to measure this last 1 year and be able to say you have done well? Today is the 52nd week, 52nd Sunday. Some people, count how many Sundays you don't come to church. Count how many times, so no, they know they near prayer meeting for Wednesday or Friday, they are just too tired. Some throughout the whole year, they have not evangelized one day. Some, because somebody is making them angry, they leave church for 3 months, 2 months, 1 month, no time. And today you want to tell me you have extra talent, you have buried it. Because the basic requirement, I'm not talking of those who walk the angle for Sunday when they made their combo. I'm not talking of that one. There are some people walk, hang them. They cannot come because of work. I also go to work, but they allow me, because I preach, they allow me to have a duty on Sunday that I can walk to 11, rush to church, and 2 o'clock, I resume. Some people know that up to four times in a year, I do that. Otherwise, I work Sundays in the night. And it's understanding that made them to give me to work Sunday in the night, so that I can come to church first. And that one, I know I come up for that place. Because I don't know where I will go now, because the one they do, I go here and there, little bit at the top, so that I can serve God. But some people, do you think that that person with 5 talents, the one with 2 talents, what do you think happened to the one with 1 talent? Because in the year, the two way people, they talk. People were insulting him. People were talking to him. Why will you go there? Why will you serve God? Why will you do this? What have you gained? You have been a Christian for years. Nothing. Because let me tell you, that God is not good at all, like what we have today in Bible study. That God is not good at all. You better don't serve. He buried the talent, buried it. Did not even put it in back. Because you allow people to manipulate the relationship. I mean, if God was not good, what did the servant do that God is giving 1 talent? Is it not benevolence? Is it not the goodness of God towards man?
Mercy.
Is it not his mercy? God gave you one. And the Bible said the seed of the mustard seed is the tiniest of all seeds. But when planted, it's the biggest tree. They gave you one that would have made you to be known all over the whole world. You said no. You are not coming to church. Somebody has made you angry. I will not support this, I will not support that, because you are angry. Do you think that people didn't talk to the 5 talents man? They didn't tell the person that, come, Rachel is a stupid woman, don't go to her again. You think that they didn't tell the one that has 2? So didn't you see that sister and that brother, the way they treat you inside the church? Before you talk, they already insult you. They see you on the road, they don't even greet you. What kind of church is that you are going to? Do you think that they didn't say to the person with 2 talents? They did. They did. That brother played you 419. Chop all your money. You say you are going to the same church. What kind of church is that? They did for them. Now that I talk, we can apply it. They did have things like that. They did have insult. The refugees had when those with paper told them, I can come out for here. Now there will not be people where they don't get paper, then they hear they talk. Now people where, I mean, they don't have book before. If they don't talk now, no means they never talk before. It is not people that we are not talking, not be refugee, they talk. They have forgotten the refugee with every mouth. But now that we are talking, it is those that have paper that are talking. Not refugee. Refugees not allowed to talk here. That refugee not become Nigeria again. They had that from the church and they still came to church. The 5 talented people. They traded because their heart was keen to God. Say, I look up to the hills, from where does my help come? Who is the one that has loved me so much and has given me 5 talents? Look at my choir. How many times? Count how many weeks you come. Count how many times you come, 10 o'clock. 10:30 to 11.
This year will change.
Amen, that is what I'm talking. That is what I'm saying, it's time for reflection. There are some people, God has blessed them. 5 euros in this box. Inshallah, may the Lord bless everyone that has been supporting through this orphanage home. We sent 120,000 euros and Amen. We sent 120,000 naira last week to bless the orphanage home. And I think during April time we gave 100,000. So making around 220,000 that we gave this home this year. So I believe that by the grace of God, that God will still, because now we are increasing gradually, that by next year we can be able to do something even greater for the orphanage home. May the Lord richly bless everyone that has been supporting our orphanage home in Nigeria. You will increase, you shall not be little in Jesus' name. So many people promise this year, God, I will serve you wholeheartedly. God, I won't miss church. God, I won't allow anybody to do it. I'm going to make sure that my prayer life changed. What did you do about it? God has been faithful. Have you been faithful? We are going to 2020. Apart from you telling God, thank you today and dancing, you still have to tell the Father, forgive me. The Bible said, I've already read Psalm 84, okay? Then we not withhold any guilty. I don't read that now. Yes. Psalm 92 tells us 10. Now you are going to another year. This is what happened. That today you cannot be able to tell yourself, if you are sincere, I was faithful to God throughout this year. You know why? Bible said that those who are planted, 10, those who are planted in the house of God, you must not allow anything as you are going to 2020. The mistake of 2019, you cannot allow it to happen in 2020. You can't allow anything to make you to be weak. You can't allow anything to make you to be disturbed. Amen. 13, sorry. You can't allow anything to make you to be disturbed. You can't allow any friend. Do you know that there are some friends that when you are with them, because they will not come to church, they will weaken you in the house? When you are getting ready to go to church, they will talk to you. That is when they will be bringing, my children, they do it to me at times. When I want to, now they have changed, but when they were younger, when I want to go to work, I'm calling them, Mama, hey Mama, come and sign this paper. Have I not been in the houses? Why is it now that you know that I will sign your assignment for you? You understand? And then I have to stop to sign assignment. Because maybe Papa is not there. Hey Mama, they said that we should bring 10 euro. Mama, they said we should bring 20. When I'm on the lift, I want to go to work. Then I have to stop. Then I bind them. I bind them, they are my children. I call them and I bind them. I say in the name of Jesus. If you children will be disturbing me, not allowing me to go to work on time, I bind you. And they were bound. Because they amen. Yes, because then they were giving me on time in the house. Yeah, it sounds like joke, it's true. Nothing where people say Satan no fit use. Not true. So I buy them and then they started doing it correctly. Otherwise it was manipulation. That time they started giving me name. Say, she comes in my space. Not beside the late right, they come punctly show, but at times if it meets with 1 minute. You know, so you book will call 15 minutes before time. So as long as you are not there, 10 minutes before time, 5 minutes before time, 15 minutes before time, you are a late comer. So I will struggle and drive rough to make sure I get there. But at times, 1 minute don't pass. They're already waiting for me. Everybody's already sitting. Waiting for me for Ubagabe. I will be rushed because my children won't make I serve them. Because they won't make I do this. Now I say that by Shakari, I must sweat at it. What am I telling you? You are going to a next year. By this time, when we will be doing the last Sunday of 2020, the kind of joy that will fill your heart because you yourself, you are convinced that this year I serve God well. You will have it in the name of Jesus. Amen. He said, those who are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. It is those who are planted that enjoy what is called flourishing. both spiritually and physically. They are masters of things because we are serving the God Almighty, Jesus, who is the master of the universe. So if you want to enjoy the boldness that follows Christianity, make sure nothing takes you away. He said they shall still bring forth fruit in old age. They shall be fat and flourishing. You need to be planted. All those mistakes you have done this year, no problem. This year don't pass. But don't let it happen next year. Amen.
Amen.
Even, what is his name? Jeffrey. Jeffrey said, he said a day, if he is a doorkeeper in the house of God, he's in the courts of God, he said it's better. It is better. In that book of Psalm 84:10, he said, for a day in the court is better than 1,000. I had rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. Do you see the mindset? In the tent. Some people Saturday throughout this year now, they go enjoy drink on Saturday. Then Sunday, to wake up, come church. Wahala. Some now follow. Friends want travel, go Italy. They want travel, go Croatia. No good thing they will follow. Be planted and you will see the change.
Amen.
Amen. We are doing reflection this morning. I'm not coming here, I can't make your belly sweet. A man who is rich, you always think in the evening, what have I achieved today? So this year, what have we achieved? We have achieved so many, but I'm only mentioning where we can do better. Because one thing that I know we achieved this year, that indeed is a year of our sufficiency. Our ego, it plays some drama, but did we come to meet anybody and say, add additional money to your money? Did we force anybody when it comes to giving? Why? God in his own way. In short, I always marvel at times. Not from outside, though, still from within. We don't have anybody sponsoring this ministry from anywhere. We have nobody sponsoring this church from nowhere. This church is still paying tithe regularly to our every nation church. We are paying our tithe to what do they call it? The friar Kirke that we belong to. We are still giving our dues. Nobody is sponsoring this church from anywhere. God has used us to be our own sponsor. But there has, I mean, turn your hands and just let us celebrate ourselves. €150 per offering, €110 offering, €80 offering. Then you go look, say, God, how this thing won't be? Before you will know, from nowhere to nowhere, 1,000 plus will go into that month. Bah! Who you touch? Because I didn't go and ask anybody. God will go by himself. He will touch people, he will knock them. Koi, what is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? I put you in this church to be the sponsor of this church. You have not been putting something. Go and cross €500 before I know. It is happening, my dear, you laugh. No, not lie, talk. No. These are the people that open the envelope. They will open envelope and find €500 inside envelope. Open envelope and find €400 or something. Before we know, that 3 times that we have added one something, we don't know where God bring the money for. All we know is that it's from this same church. We will pay our rent, we will pay extra expenses without going to anybody. So God has been faithful and he has been giving us everything that we need. Stresslessly. May God bless you all in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So when we are talking about achievement, I know. But I know that if we want to flourish, we really need to be planted. If with this our yaga way of behavior, we are still able to do like this and be like this, including myself, because I didn't walk, I don't get much time. But if with this, God can let his grace and mercy make us to be strong, what about if we give ourselves? What about if we give ourselves? What about if we have that testimony that no, God, I have been faithful. In everything you ask me to do, by your grace, I have been faithful. What about if we have that testimony? He said, we shall be fat and flourishing. For a day in the court of God is better than a thousand outside. Being a doorkeeper in the house of God is better than having companion by staying, better than staying in the tent of wickedness. I thank God for all who have been faithful. I thank God for all who have been faithful. And God will continue to bless us. So this is the end of the year. This is the end of the year. There is something that God always puts in the end of the year. The book of Psalm 65 said, 11, he said, thou crownest the year with your goodness, and the path drop fatness. Read the Bible in and out of season. But I am already said it, but for the people that were not here, read the Bible. If you say you want to grow in serving God, read your Bible, pray. But I must say, most people don't do morning devotion any longer. Pray, read your Bible. There is no two ways about it. It's not a prayer point. It's not a prayer point. Father, help me to serve you more. Father, help me to love you more. Father, make me grow spiritually. Yeah, we pray. Okay, so you say, Father, make me grow spiritually. He said those scriptures. I read it for this, through the inspiration of God. For what? For doctrine. Teaching. For doctrine. One, for doctrine. For teaching. For reproof. Everything to make you to be perfect as a saint. Even for correction, thank you. Everything. Then you did not take that word and you say, Father, I want to grow. Father, I want to have wisdom. The Bible says all wisdom is hidden in what? Okay. In Christ. Inside the Bible, inside the word of God, all wisdom is hidden. Then you are telling God, God, give me wisdom. Father, I want to have wisdom like Solomon. He said, read my Bible, I've given you wisdom already. Solomon prayed it in prayer. Blah, 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 blah. Go and do what Solomon did. 1,000 offering. Amen.
Amen.
So God has already made this thing available. If you don't go through it, you will not have it. So it's not a prayer point. You don't need that to pray. You don't stand up to pray. You don't run to pray. You only pray when you have problem. And you want to grow spiritually. How now? Tell me, how is it possible? Jesus Christ said pray. Brother Emma said it. He said Jesus Christ was always praying. Who is the kind of example? He said men ought to pray and not faint. Men ought to pray and not faint. A true man knows how to pray and not faint and fear when trouble comes. Men ought to pray and not faint. Prayer makes you to be bold, makes you to be strong, makes you to be courageous, makes you to be certain of what you believe. That connection with God makes you to be certain. He knows you believe that no matter what is happening, you have a kind of confidence in you that Satan cannot be able to touch. A kind of confidence that makes Satan to feel uneasy, that makes Satan and his coyote and all of that, they will be shaking because there is a kind of confidence in you that you know that you are with God. I am indeed planted. I know who I serve. I know who is in me. I know who is abiding in me. I know who the one in whom I trust. He said, for without faith, it is impossible for anybody to please God. That whoever must come to God must know and believe that God is God and the rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. Hebrews 11 says. So you cannot be able to stand strong if you don't diligently seek God. He said, I crown the year with goodness and your path drop fatness. They drop upon the pastures of the wilderness and the little hills rejoice on every side. I decree into your life. Even as it's remaining these 2 days, the fatness of God, the oil of God, the beauty of God will be dropped into your life.
Amen.
In your mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Remember, He's coming.
Definitely. Definitely.
Let me just use the word to do prayer for us. Psalm 65, here we are, 9. My people, God's sweet home. I tell you, God's sweet home. If you don't know, no, God's sweet home. On a pastor, I don't know to do household. I don't know cutting cars, I don't know body household. I don't get pastors around me, unless if God keeps secret people where they pray for me. That one. But I don't get one person where I go send that my prayer partner where they pray for me. Now only me and my God. For all that I know with my own knowledge, it's only me and him. But I know he must have touched one or two persons to be praying for me. That one I know. But I don't have anybody. God is sweet. If you stand with God, you will never fail. I have no other hope. No matter how the struggles is, trouble will not come and I'll say, who will I call? I don't have any pastor that said I'm running to be called. Of course, we have pastors in every nation churches, they are there. But God asks every one of them. Unless they ask me, Rachel, because we always have meeting, is there any trouble? Is there anything? Of course, we share. Then for that meeting, 10 minutes prayer. When you go now, you go do something. Go pray our 10 minutes prayer. Everybody, Father, touch her, bless her, heal the congregation in Jesus' name. In the nobody will. Till another, I mean that because of work, throughout this year now, I've not been able to go to that meeting 3 days. It was just 2 weeks ago. Because they are asking me to go to a checkup because I don't the young. So now my pastor, that's, I don't feel come the program where we go, and they go for check-up because I'm young. Now he said, what happened? I told him, fear cash out. Now he said, you're meeting. Now, since throughout the whole year, now we go Empress near my house, we sit down for about 1 hour, he's asking me questions about the need to be prayed. They check me, they don't see anything from my body, they don't give me water for nothing. Anyway, but what I'm telling you is just the simple thing that I'm telling you. It is me and God. And he has never failed me. I don't have any person that I will say I am falling back to. It's not as if it's not good to have prayer partner or praying pastors. But please, on your own, know your God. Know your God. This God that you are serving, know him. No matter how the trouble comes, God himself is looking at you and he knows that you know only him. He's not blind. He visits you, he knows you know only him. He knows that you trust only him. He can see your weakness, that you are not gathering powers all around you, that your power is his power. He knows. And he said, whoever is in God shall not be put to shame. So please hold on to God and hold on to me only. Stop depending on sisters and brothers or Christian mother and Christian fathers to be praying for you. Stop depending on pastors. You have 3-4 pastors from Nigeria. They have not finished the problem of their congregation. You say they carry your own joiner. You keep sending money to them, thinking they are fasting for you. Fast for yourself. You keep sending money to them, they are reading Bible for you. Read Bible for yourself. When a pastor no get eye for any other place. And God is my witness. Those who are very close to me are my witness. And up to now, my 51 years, going to 52 now, he has never failed me. When trouble was very strong, I did not know. I mean, that time people came and said, do this and do that. I said, such power I know. It's just like David. They said, put on the garment of Goliath. That is how it was. They asked me to put on a garment that was not my garment. And I said, I don't know how to use those things. They were only trying to help. But I rejected the help. And one of them that time said, in the last, he goes on die, but I will come down. Well, who be the person where I get the triumph? Not be me. The man sit down for my front here. Amen? Amen. Do you understand? I only need that. My sister also would front one in this thing was in Nigeria would pray. My brother would tell me they are praying. My mother said they are praying. Everybody I believe they are praying. But I did not, because of the situation, go and put my hand where I'm not supposed to put my hand. Even though it was presented to me, I said no. And because of that, I was not put to shame. And because of that, you will not be put to shame.
Amen.
Hold on to God, and God will favor you.
Amen.
And you will enjoy your life.
Amen.
And you will have confidence.
Amen.
And you will flourish.
Amen.
Because when God visits you, God will water you. God will greatly enrich you. God will make you to be full of water. That means you will give life to people. God will provide his corn for you, and he will make you to be rich in everything that you need. In your mighty name, Lord Jesus.
Amen.